Previously on Game of Thrones.
My father is planning to make a move against your family. He knows all your weaknesses, all your plans, because you have a traitor in your council. He's been sending a great deal of gold to someone in King's Landing.
We were told we'd be speaking to Lord Tyrion alone.
That's enough, Andros.
Northgrove? That's just some shit story for little kids.
I've heard stories. Old tales of a secret forest within a forest. Your lord knew what he was talking about. I'm part of the free folk. People round here call wildlings.
My true name is Sarah Flowers.
You're a bastard?
It means a lot to be able to share that with someone. Someone I can trust.
And if it isn't Elena, then more. You're not still marrying into this wretched family.
I'm sorry. I'm going to tell Father the betrothal is off.
It's a long journey to Meereen on foot.
Meereen? Shit.
What?
Unfinished business there. I don't want to talk about it.
If you presume to speak of my dragons, you best choose your words carefully.
Are you gonna be a good little forester, learn your lesson, and stay down? Don't think this is over, Roderick!
The foresters need to keep their end of the bargain. Take the boy as your ward. Kill him if they give you any trouble.
I never did tell you about your father, did I? We bled him at first, like a pig.
I knew you were a killer the day you arrived. Seems Britt found out too.
It wasn't my fault. He attacked me and we fought and...
And you threw him clear off the wall. You tried to lie about what you did to get here. But we both know you had blood on your hands. But now, you've killed one of your brothers. You'll lose your head for this, Tuttle.
This is mad! You're going to execute me!
Shut your mouth, Tuttle. A man is dead because of you. There's only one thing to be done with you now.
Hey, Frostfinger! I saw what Garrett did to Britt last night.
Yeah, he was there.
Then go on. What did you see, boy?
Garrett's telling the truth. Britt attacked him. Just like he said, Garrett had no choice but to fight back.
There isn't a man at the wall wouldn't sell his own mother for the right price. You two are up to something.
No, we're not. He's telling the truth.
You can't fault a man for defending himself.
Garrett killed a man of the watch. There's a price to be paid for that. Let's go. I knew it was a mistake to make you a ranger.
Frostfinger! What's to be done with him?
We're heading to Crusted.
You'll have to find someone else for your expedition. Your man here still has a lot to answer for. Now out of the way, Snow.
Give us a moment.
Then kiss him quick and be done with it.
Garrett, you told me you wouldn't get into it with Britt. What happened?
Sorry I let you down, John. I didn't mean for it to come to this.
You gave me your word, Garrett. It can't have been easy. Facing the man who killed your family.
Aye.
Is there nothing to be done?
Aside from removing Tuttle's head from his shoulders? No.
But
you're about to go off and execute a nest full of traitors at Craster's. How is this any different?
Godspeed with you, Garrett.
We're down a man, so keep your eyes open. Now let's move.
You can go begging to your gods all you want, boy. It's the Axe has the final say.
Do you know how many men have stood before me with false tales of my dragons? Desperate men, hoping for wealth, protection. Liars, every one of them.
Maybe you should get to know me better. I'm not like those other men.
You sure look like the rest of them. Covered in dirt. Are you frightened? I thought you'd seen a dragon before.
He's much smaller than the other one.
Would you like to touch him? Go ahead. Unless you are afraid. Of course. A man who has really faced a dragon before may have reason to be afraid.
Oh, fuck.
You're brave, at least.
I don't think he likes me.
You still have a hand, don't you? You claim you saw Drogon. Give me a reason to believe you.
Have this.
Drogon, how did you get that? What have you done to him? If you've hurt him...
Hurt him?
He attacked us.
Drogon wouldn't strike without reason. You must have scared him.
A child who can breathe fire on whoever he likes.
The men who were following us, the Lost Legion, they drew their swords and tried to fight him.
And Drogon defended himself.
So we somehow deserve to be burnt alive because your little baby was scared. Your tongue is dangerously sharp, sellsword. Why did you come here? You offer me nothing but lies. To what end? You want gold? A title?
Don't want your money. I just need your help.
Help very often means money.
My family is depending on me. I have to find an army.
An army?
If you could spare some of your sellswords.
Please, if...
I also came here looking for an army. But what I found were the cries of children and people suffering in chains while their masters profited from their misery. My sellswords will help me free the slaves of Marine. That is their mission.
I would only need a few men. Those who follow Croft could come with me, the rest are yours.
They are all mine.
There must be something I can do to convince you.
As we speak, my men prepare to enter Marine. What they are about to do is much bigger than you or I. Bigger than one family back in Westeros. So, unless you think you can storm Marine and free all the slaves yourself...
You have nothing more to offer me,
Croft.
We're not just sellswords. We're the best damn sellswords in Slaver's Bay.
I know a few who might disagree with you.
His boasting aside, they were two of my best fighters.
And Beskar here, she has a history in Marine. She could help guide us.
What the hell?
Is this true?
Yes. I lived in Marine for a time. On the eastern side of the city.
Fucking bastard.
So you wish to accompany them? You'd help the Second Sons? Guide them into Marine?
I can't, Asha.
This could be our only chance.
Anything for you.
Within reason, of course.
Very well. You two will join Croft and his men. Get them into the city, help them liberate Marine, and I will see that you are rewarded. But your uncle stays here. If I find you've lied or put my men in danger...
I understand.
Good. Croft will get you settled in. It's going to be a long night.
The fuck happened back there? Are we really going into Marine?
Look, I'm sorry it happened this way.
As long as you get your army, right?
Beskar.
Get your armor patched up in here. Extra bedrolls if you need them. Piss buckets in the corner where it's always fucking been.
Long time since you had a piss bucket.
I spent 2 years trying to get where I am now. Don't fuck this up for me, Asha. Nail! We got two more!
It's not your leg that's the problem, Roderick. You've got to be practical. You got the best of Griff last time. When he comes looking for revenge, do you think you can beat him?
Next time I face Griff, it will be the last. I won't let him parade around my halls any longer.
I look forward to it, my lord. But you won't win a fair fight. You can't handle a sword like you used to. So find another advantage. Surprise your opponent. Do something unexpected.
Like what?
I'll show you. Come at me.
bring your opponent down to your level.
When I attack you, drop down, avoid my blade, and swing at the back of my knees. Wait for me to attack.
Roderick!
Let's try it again.
Almost.
Again.
Now that's how you do it.
I think you let me. Oh.
My lord, sorry to interrupt.
Elena?
She insisted on seeing you immediately.
Lady Elena, I'm sorry to hear we won't be sisters.
Talia. Roderick, can I speak with you? Privately. You remember my little brother?
Quiver! Good gods, you've grown.
You could just call me Arthur now.
I hope you don't mind us coming unannounced. But something's happened.
I didn't know if I would see you again. Given how we left things.
That doesn't change how I feel about you, Roderick. Truth be told, you're the only one I can turn to. Lord Whitehill paid my father a visit at Realwater Crossing. He told my father you were disobeying Griff's authority and...
And he wanted to teach you a lesson.
As if I'm some token to be handed around.
You mean...
He demanded I marry his son, Griff.
What?
Lud threatened my family. Told my father if he refused, we'd be slaughtered along with you.
Father acted the damn coward.
He agreed, Roderick.
Then you have to defy your father.
I intend to. Do you think I want to marry that disgusting pig? But my father won't listen. I'm not gonna be the bone they throw that howling dog. I'm not gonna be some prize for him to rip open. We have to get rid of him.
It's time someone brought Griff down.
We were hoping you'd say that.
You brought your men.
I command Father's elite guard. These men are trained archers, swordsmen, experts in both ranged and close combat. They're yours, if you'll help us take down Griff.
The whole guard?
20 men. My father still thinks they're aboard a ship bound for the Reach. What do you have to lose, Roderick?
I have to decide what's best for my house.
I know that. I know this might sound mad, but it's the only way. Get rid of Griff, and you'll be free to use the guard however you like. You can finally take control of your house again. Please, promise me you'll do this.
Would be happy to.
Thank you, Roderick.
Griff won't even see it coming. My men are yours to command.
Thank you, Quip. Arthur.
Could you give us a moment? You don't know how much this means to me. I'm sorry I couldn't marry you before. Maybe when this is all over, we could play hide-and-seek in the grove again.
Like that very much, Elena.
Then you know where to find me.
I believe it's another coronation already. Our kings just get younger and younger.
Tommen's not ready. He's too soft.
Maybe that was the imp's plan.
I wonder if Marjorie Tyrell will be there today.
You mean Queen Marjorie? She was married to Joffrey.
For all of 1 hour.
I fancy she'll marry his brother too. Not to mention Cersei and Jaime. Shh. The Lannisters have spies everywhere.
What is it, Tom?
Remember that warning you'd heard from Roderick?
About Whitehill's contact. Did you find anything?
Only whispers. But your brother's right. Lud Whitehill. Lord Whitehill is sending a great deal of gold to someone here in King's Landing.
Well done, Tom. Did you hear anything else?
Lord Whitehill is surprisingly secretive. The only people I'm even certain he deals with are those ironwood merchants. They'll both be at the feast after Tommen's coronation today. Maybe you can learn something.
I can't go. Marjorie's... she's not exactly happy with me right now. I've been uninvited.
Couldn't Sarah help? Ask her to get you in.
We are friends. I'm sure she'd help if I asked her.
It's a good plan, then.
It's nearly time.
Just be careful, Lady Mira. King's Landing seems to have it in for you.
What are you doing out here? There's leftover honey cake in the kitchens.
Have to guard this one. Locked him up in the old storeroom until morning.
That the one who killed Brit? He's not going anywhere. Come on. He'll be back before anyone notices.
All right. Maybe just a quick bite. He's likely to freeze to death out here anyway.
That might be useful.
Garrett!
Cotter, what are you doing here?
I heard him talking. You're to be executed in the morning.
What about Finn? He told
them... Nobody believes him. Or don't want to. They think he's covering for you. Some are even saying he helped you do it.
I have to get out of here.
That's why I came. I want to help.
You'd be executed too. Why would you want to help me?
You had my back with Finn. He would have killed me over that knife. I figured it was about time I returned the favor.
I owe you for this. If we make it out alive...
Well, now that you mention it...
What?
I want to go with you, Garrett. To the North Grove. You know I can't stay here. I'm leaving Castle Black, but I'd rather not go it alone. So if you're going north, I'm coming with you.
Well, I'm not going anywhere unless I can get out of this bloody storeroom first.
I can try and pick the lock, but I'm not sure it will work. Garrett, what are you doing?
Getting out of here.
See it? It's coming loose.
I'm gonna try to push it out. You pull, all right?
I hope no one heard that. Hey, can you fit through?
I think. You two idiots, lucky I'm not Frostfinger.
Finn, you bastard. What are you doing here?
Arm the sword in the darkness. Helping a fellow brother keep his head. You'll need this. Now, let's go.
You're not coming with us, Finn.
What are you on about? Frostfinger already thinks I'm helping you. What do you think he's gonna do when he hears you've run off with Potato Fucker over here? I'd rather take my chances with you. And I'm good in a fight, you know that.
Yeah, good at starting them anyway.
Having another ranger along couldn't hurt.
Till he stabs you in the back.
We'll talk later. Move!
There's no turning back now. We're deserters for sure. We're breaking our vows.
I've taken plenty of oaths. Broken plenty too.
Family back home is counting on me to put things right. And I mean to do it. Vows aren't going to stop me.
They know we're gone now.
Then how fast can you run?
What's wrong, Mother?
It's Griff. He was arguing with the Maester and things got out of hand.
I'm coming.
What do you mean to do?
He's gonna see what happens when you harm a member of my family.
And mine. The rest of my men are still in the grove.
Make sure they're ready to do some damage.
Sounds like a good time. Let's go.
And Arthur. Listen for my signal. I'll strike my cane when I want you to enter.
We'll be ready.
I'm coming with you.
It's not safe. You should wait for your brother.
I don't care if it isn't safe. Griff thinks I belong to him. I need to show him I don't.
Together then.
Here. Roderick!
Help me.
Tell your dog to obey his new master. And while you're at it, Elena Glenmore! What are you doing with him? You're supposed to be marrying
you!
Me.
I'd rather marry a dead horse.
She'll never marry you, Griff. She'll do what she's told. And so will he, when I'm through with him. You should have set a better example.
Listen! You're not the Lord here, Griff. And I'm tired of you pretending you are.
You think I'm fucking pretending?
You know what I think?
My brother is ready.
I think you need another lesson in humility!
Actually, I think it's your turn.
I don't think so, Roderick! Oh, what's the cripple up to now, eh? Fancy yourself a warrior? You are nothing, Roderick! Just give up. Not today. Accept it. You're just embarrassing. What are your orders?
Kill anyone that moves!
You heard him! Stand down! You can't do this!
Now then, about humility.
Get your hands off me!
Maester, are you alright?
Yes, I think so.
I did warn you, Griff.
You gonna hurt me? Your friends won't be around forever, Roderick. And when they're gone, I will see that you pay for this! Is this the man you'd rather have? This cripple?
I think... Roderick!
Enough! That's enough! Are you satisfied?
You need to stop.
My eye!
Roderick, listen to me!
Fucking... My eye! I can't see!
Roderick!
Oh, you fuck!
I yield! You'll kill him! Do it, Roderick! No! No, you can't!
Why are you protecting him?
I'm not protecting him, I'm protecting Ryan! When Lud hears of this, don't you realize what they'll do to him?
Get out of my way!
I can't do that. I want him dead, believe me. But not at the cost of Ryan's life. Besides, he may still be useful to us.
It's all right, Roderick.
Confine the White Hills to the cellars. No one gets in or out. I can't see anything.
Word cannot reach High Point. You must be sure of it. Not until we want it to. Kill the Ravens. All of them.
Fuck you and your queen.
That's enough! So long as you're in my camp, you will obey my orders. And getting pissed drunk before a mission.
Obey?
You know what kind of shit-brained fool does that? One who wants to fucking die out there! Have you lost your damn-
Hey, calm down! Calm down! What's going on here?
I'm not the one with the problem. It's him.
She can't fight like this, Asher!
You think I'm too drunk to fight? What the fuck
do you
know?
What are you gonna do? Run out there swinging a fucking-
Still think I can't fight?
Hey, come on, Beska. Leave the poor man alone.
Let go of me before I break your fingers.
Deal with your friend! She'll get us all
you
killed!
You sound scared, Croft.
I'll talk to her.
Good. If she can't hold it together, we're leaving without the both of you.
You think your little thumbcock can take Marine all by itself? I'd never work with a bloody show like you,
Beska,
anyway!
What the hell is going on?
You gonna lecture me too?
The fuck? You can't let him get to you. You're better than that.
It's not just him. You think I give two shits about what Croft has to say?
Your fucking uncle is the only reason I'm even here.
He told your little dragon queen I would go into Marine with you.
I'm doing this for my family, Beska. This is the only way.
Always about you. your family, your problems. Come on, Asher.
Hit me.
I'm not going to do that. What are you so afraid of?
I was a slave. Here, in this fucking city.
I was taken from my home when I was only 3 years old. When I was 7, my master threw me in the fighting pit to die. When my master tired of watching me kill animals for sport, he started sending other children. I butchered every one of them.
But it made you strong, didn't it?
You say that like it makes it worth it. There was this boy. We used to play five stones in the alley when we couldn't sleep. When I saw him next, he was in that pit with me. I saw the fear in his eyes. That same fear I felt my first time. And I realized it hadn't left me. I still wanted to live. I wanted it so badly.
I'm so sorry, Beskar.
I don't want your pity. I bought my freedom a long time ago, but I have always hated this place. Hated him. Dezor Zoraza. Because of that man. Marine is a city of dead children. Don't worry about me. I won't let you down.
I know you won't.
You shouldn't say that.
Why not?
Mira, I'll meet you inside. What are you doing here? I have to get in there, Sarah. I know I'm not supposed to attend, but then you know Lady Marjorie doesn't want to see you. What could be so important? Lord Whitehill is up to something. He's conspiring against my family. And someone in there is helping him.
Lady Marjorie would be furious, Mira. I can't.
The blame. You can tell Marjorie I snuck in and you tried to stop me.
She's already thinking about replacing you. Are you sure you want to risk it?
I have to.
All right. You owe me for this. She's with me. We'll stay out of trouble. I promise. Feels a bit strange to celebrate, doesn't it? Not so long ago, King Joffrey sat on the Iron Throne.
Tommen is our king now.
Long may he reign.
Sarah! I was worried you'd run off with your friend there.
And what if I did?
I'm not sure I could blame you.
This is Lady Mira Forrester. Mira, Lord Garibald Tarwick.
She's quite lovely.
You flatter me. Sarah's lovelier than us all.
I won't argue there. It's quite a feast, isn't it? Just be careful around the wine. I hear you're partial to a particular Arbor Red. It's easy to forget. Nothing you do in King's Landing goes unnoticed. Drink too much once and you're forever the drunken fool. Talk to the wrong people and...
Oh, Lord Tarwick!
What was that about?
Nothing. That subject isn't fit for your delicate ears anyway.
My ears are not delicate.
Of course they are. Look how tiny they are. Little loads.
Stop it.
What?
I mean it. Someone caught your eye, Mira? My apologies. I just noticed Lords Andros and Morgrin over there.
What a shame. Ruining a perfectly good afternoon with that nonsense.
Perhaps someone should encourage them to argue elsewhere. If you'll excuse me.
This reminds me of the tourney at Lannisport. You wouldn't believe them.
You've told me this story.
But you would have loved it. We danced all evening, drank wine from our helmets.
That is it!
Andros, you're being ridiculous!
Why would you ever stop dealing ironwood?
Is there no longer a demand?
I can't imagine that would be the case.
No need for such wild speculation. I've simply lost interest. I'm moving on to better things, as they say.
And what would that be?
No. I can see what you're doing. I'm not giving away my secrets just yet.
It is a lot, but I know how to spend.
But how did you manage it?
Lord Whitehill trusts me above all others. That's why I'm the only one he's willing to work with.
Oh, an exclusive deal. How good for you, Andros.
Well, I've got my family to consider.
When's the last time you even saw your wife, Andros?
Oh, I can't remember. I think it was a bird?
Close.
A cock.
That's it.
No, that's terrible.
You're the one telling the joke, remember?
I heard he was killed. Right here in the garden.
Well...
Wasn't he a Lannister?
One of their guard, but still.
Surely they've found who did it.
No, they haven't caught him yet. Not for lack of effort, mind you. I hear they've spared no expense. Lord Andros?
Mira Forrester. Did you come to poke your nose in my business once again?
You and Lord Morgrin don't seem to be getting along. Something the matter?
Lord Morgrin? That is none of your concern, Lady Mira. You have no idea what you're up against.
Why don't you tell me then?
You think you and your friend Morgrin scare me?
Who said Morgrin was my friend?
Don't play innocent with me. I know what he's planning.
You can tell him that either you both stay out of my way,
or I'll do much worse than drive him out of business. Good day, Lady Mira.
Please, if you'll excuse me.
Lady Mira, I'm impressed.
Impressed with what?
That you aren't currently locked in a cell. I trust this means that you took care of that contract. How did you do it, if I may ask?
I tell you how I did it. What's in it for me?
Nothing. But I admire the gall. I do believe King's Landing is rubbing off on you. So, what have you been up to?
When we first met, you were negotiating for Lord Whitehill.
That's right.
But now Lord Andros seems to think he's the only one working for him. So what happened?
It appears that you know most of the story already. I've been pushed out of the ironwood business.
Oh.
All thanks to my partner. Bloody imbecile. Andros is now Lord Whitehill's exclusive contact in King's Landing.
Why would Lord Andros want to push you out?
You found a man he could manipulate. Someone who wouldn't demand an equal share. Lyman Lannister.
He's working with a Lannister?
A third cousin, to be fair. Whatever Andros is up to, he clearly thinks Lyman can take my place.
Rickard! Are you done flirting with that handmaiden? We need your opinion here.
Leave him alone.
Please excuse me.
Excuse me. Lyman Lannister?
Shit.
I'm so sorry. I shouldn't have...
No, it's not your fault. I just get clumsy sometimes. I'm afraid you have me at a disadvantage, Lady...
Mira.
Lady Mira. I'm not used to being approached so boldly. But I'm glad you did. I always feel a bit out of place at big gatherings like this. So, what brings you over here?
From what I hear, you're in the business of making rather important deals happen.
Well, I don't know about that.
Come on, don't be modest.
I really shouldn't talk about it. Andros came to me in confidence.
If you like, you can whisper it in my ear.
Well, I suppose I could just...
Lyman! What do you think you're doing?
What? Nothing.
You stay away from him.
Andros! We were just talking.
You were just talking to Mira Forrester.
Forrester? I didn't realize.
My lord?
Let me say this as plainly as I can. Don't ever meddle in my affairs again!
Lady Marjorie. Lady Marjorie.
Lady Mira? That was quite a scene over there. Are you all right?
I'm fine. I can handle Lord Andros.
It's Lyman I was worried about.
What do you mean?
Honestly, that story isn't fit for a maiden's ears.
Just tell me, Lord Tarwick. It's important.
I may be willing to tell you. If you'll first tell me something about Sarah. Your help could save me a lot of embarrassment. I'd be very grateful, Lady Mira.
What do you want to know about Sarah?
Sarah Durwell. Interesting name, that. Funny thing is, the last Durwells died off almost 200 years ago. What can you tell me about her family? Something isn't quite right.
I really couldn't say, my lord.
Spare me the pretense. You know her as well as anybody. Now tell me the truth.
She asked me not to tell anyone. But Sarah is a bastard.
Are you certain?
She was born Sarah Flowers. The Tyrells renamed her.
How incredibly disappointing.
You can't tell Sarah I told you. Please.
No, you have my word. Thank you for being honest with me.
It was the least I could do. And now, Lord Tarwick, it's your turn.
Right. Lyman Lannister. 10 years ago, Lyman was injured at the tourney at Lannisport. He took a bad fall from his horse, needed milk of the poppy for weeks just to keep from screaming.
Oh.
And between us, he's never stopped drinking the stuff. Can't stop, actually. He spent all his money trying to get more. The man can't go a day without it.
So that's why he shakes.
You mustn't repeat that, Lady Mira. I shouldn't even know about it.
And why did you tell me?
Because of... Well, Maybe I shouldn't have. I'd hate for Lord Andros to trace this back to me.
You learned that from Andros?
The man's mouth is bigger than the Blackwater. Poor Lyman has no idea. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have some arrangements to undo. Lady Mira?
Lord Lyman, we really need to talk.
I know what you're up to. I won't discuss my business with Andros, so please, please, just leave me alone.
Look at you. You're shaking.
It's an old injury.
But there's more to it than that, isn't there?
What are you saying?
Lord Andros has betrayed you. I know everything.
What? What do you...
The milk of the poppy. You drink it like wine. Ever since your injury at Lannisport.
He wouldn't... Andros wouldn't...
He's not your friend. He's been using you.
I trusted him.
He spilled your secrets. So why not spill his?
Andros is hiring sellswords. Hundreds of them.
What?
He's building an army for Lord Whitehill, big enough to march against Ironwrath. But Andros is doing it in secret. No one knows.
And you're helping him?
Yes, I've helped gather the men, but that doesn't... You bloody traitor. You promised me! Then you told everyone?
What are you talking about?
You're a liar. I should never have trusted you. She told me everything.
Lady Mira, you've just made a very grave error.
Don't tell me you're afraid of a handmaiden.
You sure you know where you're going?
Cotta?
Let's see that map again.
So you're asking now, are you?
Surprised you haven't taken it from my pocket already.
How much food we got left?
Here we are.
But this won't last much longer.
If Finn wasn't eating all of it.
It's not me.
Oh, we'll have to stop soon. Look for some food.
We're on the right track. This way.
The free folk.
Oh, things.
Oh, this complicates things. You stay here. I'll try and talk to her. I'm one of them.
What? He's a fucking wildling, Cotter!
They might kick me around a little, but whatever you do, don't come out, alright? She has to think I'm alone. If she sees you, you'll only make things worse.
Good on, Ting.
No, I'm a friend.
I grew up near Ardholm. You know it? I won't hurt you. All right.
You won't.
I'm one of you.
You sure look like a crow to
me.
You're dressed like one.
You out here all alone, little pup. Come out or I'll kill your friend!
He'll be all right. Won't he?
Stop! Please!
You don't like it! You best hope your little crow brothers come looking for you soon.
Garrett!
Kill them!
Fighting you! It's over! Just don't do it!
Are those the last of our supplies?
We can't stay here.
You're hurt.
Come on! We can rest up ahead!
Feel better seeing Griff dragged out of the Great Hall like that. You wanted to kill him, didn't you? How did you know when to stop?
I didn't. I didn't know how to stop myself. Mother hadn't stepped in, I'd have killed him.
What do you think Lord Whitehill will do when he hears? If he truly has a spy...
He won't know of this. Not until we want him to.
The gates are barred and every raven in the rookery is dead.
My lord, there's been a message from High Point. Lord Whitehill invites you to discuss a truce.
He wants to make peace.
As if we're that naive.
Maybe this is an opportunity, a way to get behind their walls.
And do what?
We could get Ryan back. This could be our chance.
You're right. Now that we have Griff, we can propose a trade.
A trade? His son for my brother. Then we have a plan. We'll leave first thing tomorrow morning.
If you're going ahead with this, at least bring the Glenmore soldiers.
We obviously need them here.
You can't mean for Roderick to travel unprotected.
What if the White Hills attack Ironwrath while he's gone?
We'll need the Glenmores at High Point. They'll accompany us.
Yes, my lord.
Let Arthur Glenmore know at once.
I'll start making the preparations.
To think that one of them might be spying for the White Hills.
Duncan wanted you to travel to High Point without any protection.
Yet Roiland would leave Ironwrath defenseless.
Well, we'll need an advisor with me at High Point.
By rights, it should be your sentinel. But for something this delicate, perhaps you best take Duncan.
You're going to an enemy stronghold. Surely you want your master at arms.
Roiland's my sentinel. He comes to High Point. Duncan can stay here and defend Ironwrath.
Very well.
Roderick, I know I can't come to High Point, but I can't just sit around and do nothing. I want to help.
Talia, I may be leaving you here with a traitor. Find out who it is. Find proof if you can.
I'll do my best.
I have faith in you, Talia. I've known Lud Whitehill a long time. He's selfish, greedy, and arrogant. But he'd never kill a guest in his own home. At least, I don't think he would.
I hope you're right, Mother. Welcome.
Don't worry about me. Focus on the mission. Your family needs you.
You're my family too, Malcolm.
And I couldn't be prouder of you. Good luck, my boy.
Shall we begin?
Listen up! There are four of these guard posts throughout the city. They'll use them to warn the masters in case the slaves decide they're tired of wearing chains. We're here to make sure they don't see it coming. Therund, you take the north. Penn, the south. Asher, we'll take the east. And Kieran will cover the west. Make the enemy blind. Give the Unsullied a chance to get in and arm the slaves. The rest is up to them. Don't get cocky out there. One mistake, and the man
you
at
remember
your
when we stole that giant warhammer?
Get in, do
from
what
that
you have
woman
to
in
do,
Lise.
And get your people.
Didn't
out
she hit you in the face with it?
That's all you
I
need
never
to care
thought
about.
My head could feel any
you
worse.
You got that.
Tonight, any man who wishes to be free may take that freedom from the grip of his master. You will clear a path for them, but they must walk it alone. Justice belongs to the people of Meereen. Do not make them wait any longer.
What does she know of justice?
Is there a problem?
You don't have to worry about us. Just point us at the people you want dead. We'll take it from there.
You enjoy this far more than you should. Kill only those you must. You will both do as Croft commands. Follow his orders exactly, or you will get nothing.
Now go. Show them the hell they have made here.
Hoped I'd never see this place again. Tried to run once. Didn't make it very far.
Which way?
There's a path around there. Voids the main street. Let's just get this over with. What's the matter, Croft?
You see how many guards are out there? How were you expecting to get past them? We'll be caught.
You asked me which way. This is it.
Then we'll stay out of sight. Follow me.
Can you see anyone?
Cover me. Oh.
Been used recently. Skuda juntas, wa.
Yelwa Misha, Maya's liwash. Shall she liwash?
Spalsa washka.
Maya's liwash.
We have to go.
There's something I have to do.
Beska, what are you doing?
Do you trust me, Asher?
We don't have time for this.
Now you're worrying me, Beska. What is going on?
Don't worry. It'll be fine soon enough.
Beska!
Where are you going?
Follow her!
Why are
you doing this?
10 years ago!
Beska! No!
I should have killed you!
Beska!
I should have fucking killed you!
Beska!
He was my master. Dezo Zoraza.
Nobody can blame you for wanting him dead. Do what you must.
I will.
Have you lost your mind? I'm ordering you to back away.
My Beska.
I am not your...
Let him go!
What are you doing?
I shoot. You will do as I say. Both of you, take her weapon.
I need to do this, Asher. After everything he's done.
And he'll pay for it. Once the city is free, he will be punished.
Punished by a queen who has no right to. His life means nothing to her. She does not speak for the children who died in those pits.
Asher, stop her!
Asher!
There!
How could... That wasn't your blood to take!
Do you have any idea what you've done? The Mother of Dragons will have your head for that!
Not before we finish the job. Now let's go.
Over there! So when were you gonna tell me he's a fucking wildling? Not now, Finn. Come on. What the hell is this place?
An old haunting camp. We can rest here.
Until your friends attack us again.
I know the signs, all right? It's abandoned.
I'm gonna go make sure nobody's lurking around out here. Don't trust this fucking place.
Fine.
Here. Let me take a look at it.
Ha! If you're not gonna help, just leave it alone.
Oh, you got anything to drink?
This far north and I still have to fetch the fucking wine.
Some water or something. Please.
I'll see what I can find.
Oh, I've seen this before.
Don't move. I'm warning you. Or I'll gut you like a fucking fish. You do look like a sad little fish, don't you?
My friend is hurt. We're just looking for a place to rest.
There are others with you.
Step back! Want to kill her yourself, or should I do it? Garrett!
Just let us go. We'll leave. That's what you want, isn't it?
Cotter!
Oh, Sylvie.
You're alive!
Who's this fucking Snowball?
I told you I'd come back.
You're planning on introducing us, Cotter?
Right. This is my sister, Sylvie. She's the reason I brought you here. She can take us to the North Grove.
Lord Roderick. Lady Alyssa.
Gwyn.
And... Arthur Glenmore. I don't recall you being invited.
Yet here I am.
Roderick, may I have a word? What were you thinking? Bringing those soldiers here is sure to set my father off.
The Glenmores have sided with us. I want him to know it.
I need you to cooperate today, Roderick.
And why would I do that?
I wanted us to work together, but you refused. So now my father is doing this his way. If you value your life and your family, you'll listen to what he has to say.
I'm here in good faith, aren't I?
That doesn't look like good faith to me.
There are lords who wield power. And lords who like to make a show of it.
These walls hold 1,000 years of Whitehill history.
1,000 years of bloodshed.
But our houses were close once, and could be again. So much of our history has been lost.
Shall we get on with it?
The Great Hall is this way.
Your soldiers seem on edge.
Well, what do you expect? The way they see it, the enemy is within their walls.
What's this?
M'lady?
Give us a moment.
Is this your family?
Shortly before Griff was born.
These your brothers?
The eldest three, yes. Carl died of grayscale a few years ago. Ebbett's at the Citadel. Torin serves Roose Bolton. And Griff, of course, wasn't born yet.
Your father doesn't smile much, does he?
He used to, when my mother was still alive.
Is that your mother?
Yes. Though I hardly remember her. She died not long after this was made.
That must be you.
A much younger me, yes.
You look a bit like your mother now.
My brothers were never kind to Griff. He was boastful, gullible, and quick to anger. But my father always defended him. A White Hill is a White Hill, he'd say. Come on, we mustn't keep my father waiting.
Where's your father?
Strange. I'll go find him. I don't like this.
Don't show fear. That's what he wants.
Ryan for Griff, that's still our plan.
If anyone here should be afraid, it's Whitehill.
Agreed.
Let's have a look around, see what we find.
What's Lord Whitehill planning?
Bloodshed, most likely. We won't go down without a fight.
Just follow my lead, whatever happens. Why all this?
If they mean to betray us.
Bread and salt would mean we're protected by Guestrite.
He's testing us, seeing what we're made of.
Protect my people, get them out alive.
I'll defend them with my life. And if it does come to violence, move to the walls and get behind my men.
Bard from the other side.
Roderick! Welcome to High Point.
Lord,
my men say you've been acting a bit tense. You're not nervous, are you?
I could ask you the same thing. All these soldiers.
I wasn't the one who invited the Glenmores.
Father, please. Can we just get on with this?
Well? Your father once called High Point a keep for the gods. What stonework, he said. What craftsmanship.
Not here to admire your home.
Surely there's time to reminisce about old friends.
Gregor was not your friend. Lud, where's Ryan?
Always worried about your family, aren't you? Let's toast to family!
No. To justice.
To justice, then.
Now, as lovely as this is, I presume we have business to discuss.
Indeed we do. The Ironwood business is thriving, Roderick. In fact, the Boltons want weapons faster than we can make them.
So, in other words, you need our help.
Don't be so damn full of yourself. You foresters are headed for destruction.
Yet,
you know more about Ironwood than any house in the realm. Would be a shame for all that knowledge to be lost. Help me craft Ironwood for the Boltons, and I'll make sure you foresters survive.
You're proposing an alliance.
An alliance? I said nothing of the sort.
He'd make us his slaves.
Roderick, this could save your house.
I'd consider an alliance.
You see what I have to put up with?
Just give him time. I told you...
I offer you peace, and you spit at it. I offer opportunity, and you demand more. I've seen this coming since you refused to kiss my ring. Here's how it's gonna go, Roderick. Either you agree to my terms, or I'll have Griff tear Ironwrath to the ground.
Griff won't be doing a damn thing.
What do you mean?
He's locked in our darkest cellar along with your entire fucking garrison.
You didn't.
You've imprisoned my son.
Now it's my turn to propose a deal. Your son Griff for my brother Ryan.
We want Ryan back, and we want him today.
Bring the boy!
Ryan! Mother! Roderick! I thought you'd forgotten about me.
No!
Father, no!
What are you doing?
You imprisoned my flesh and blood.
Mine!
A son for a son!
This is not what we agreed.
Blame him! Not me.
If you want to see Griff alive again...
You think I give two shits about Griff? About my fucking fourthborn? I want to kill you right now! Because you foresters never learn.
I'm not afraid of you!
Just say the word! I'll take your Ironwood, dear. If you make the trade. Come on, Blood. Things don't have to end this way.
You're lucky I know mercy.
Ryan, come here.
No. We'll make the trade on neutral soil. Griff for Ryan. A son for a son.
Fine.
Now, get the fuck out of my hall! And the gods have mercy on us both when the Boltons come for their Ironwood.
Won't be long, Lord. And when they come, I hope that bastard flays you alive.
I'm so sorry, Lord.
There it is. The East Watcher.
Now listen up. None of those guards can live long enough to light that beacon. Because if they do, this invasion gets a whole lot fucking harder. Don't drop that.
How many men do you think are in there?
Hard to know for sure. At least five, maybe more. To answer your question, too many to fight head on.
We'll need to take those two out first. Is that a harpy?
Of course it is. Those golden tits are everywhere in this bloody city. If those guards light the rope, the fire travels up to the bowl, and the whole city will know we're here.
So we stop them.
Aye.
Come on, let's get moving. Beskar.
It's nothing. Just forget it.
Focus. We have to move. This mission won't wait for us.
That's all you care about.
I'll take him.
I've got the other one.
Just keep an eye on her.
I don't need him to watch me.
Then prove it!
What have you heard?
Just sit outside the gates waiting.
Mother of dragons. She wants to scare us, but she won't do it. Not a...
We'll split up. One group will go high and try to climb over to the other side.
What about them?
That's why someone needs to stay down here. They get behind cover and shoot the men up top. Just don't let that one see you. So, which'll it be?
You want to be the leader, you decide.
I'll go over the top. You just make sure to clear the way.
I think he got the easy job.
What happened?
Not important. Keep moving. Quick. Guards on the roof.
We'll take care of it.
I'll get rid of them.
I've got it. Go!
I know what I'm doing. Doesn't look like you do. Little rat.
You say something? Well?
I said you're a little rat. Why are you laughing?
Nothing. Just keep doing it, Douglas. Just tell me when you're falling.
You will have to see how you like it.
Down there? Hey!
secure the beacon. They break through. I'll keep them busy.
We can finish this. Just look at them. Two men. We've dealt with worse. Let's rush them and be done with it.
What about them?
You afraid of a couple of crossbows?
We stick to Croft's plan. Take care of them first.
All right. Oh, I can't believe you did it.
Croft!
Croft!
Quit your whimpering. I'm not dead yet.
You hear that?
It's starting.
Last. Back at High Point, I wasn't sure your brother would survive the day.
He nearly didn't.
But you kept your head and took Lud's deal. And now Ryan will be coming home.
We'll celebrate once Ryan has returned safely. We still need to make the trade.
You're right, of course. Still, you did well today. Don't lose sight of that.
My lord, look.
Where are the guards?
Dahlia? Duncan?
Where's my sister?
Elena!
Where's anybody?
Wait here.
Come on. Don't be so dreary. It was a joke.
I'm sorry, I should have laughed.
Or maybe you think you can do better.
Of course not. I didn't mean to offend you.
Perhaps a song instead. I hear you've written a touching song about your dead brother. Am I in it? Let's hear it, shall we?
No.
No?
Roderick!
Roderick!
Lord Ramsay, welcome to Ironwrath.
How courteous. Now I know where your sister gets her manners. We've had a lovely time together, haven't we, Talia? Say it. Say it's been lovely.
It's been lovely.
And you? I'm told you're a man who can't be broken. I've decided to come see for myself. Ethan was the first forester I killed. Doesn't have to be the last.
You don't know what you're in for, Garrett. What you're asking my brother to do. The North Brove isn't what you think it is.
You claim to be a leader, yet your own people do not respect you.
But we did as you commanded!
These aren't sellswords, Asher. They're killers.
Roderick!
I can't believe I trusted him.
I know you and my brother were in contact. Perhaps he told you things. Things that might prove his guilt. Perhaps you are not to be trusted either.
Oh, you're not listening, Garrett.
Shh!